Okay, so this is all about dynamic timing analysis. So far we have covered manual analysis and dynamic timing analysis. The third one is static timing analysis. Static timing analysis uses a netlist timing information from the boundary of a circuit and primitive delay information to trace paths in a circuit and verify whether the timing requirements defined for the input of the flip-flop in the circuit are satisfied. Getting? Here we are not going to give any input vectors. Simply we are going to give our netlist and constraints. Then the tool will automatically do the analysis on each and every path, and it will give come up with some results whether your the constraints you met are satisfied or met or not, or it's violated. It will tell all these things. So this is also, I can say, this is also one kind of manual analysis, the extension of manual analysis. For a small circuit, we can easily append the delay produced by each and every component. For a big circuit, it's not possible. That's why we need some automation, right? So the tool is doing that automation. It will simply add all the delays produced by each and every path, and it is calculating. Right, adding up the propagation delay along paths between the clocked elements in a circuit. This is popular among the digital logic designers. So this is all about the intro of static timing analysis. What is static timing analysis? I hope now you will get the difference between the static and the dynamic analysis, timing analysis. Right. So this is also having its own advantages and disadvantages. For example, advantages: it resembles manual analysis, as I told now. And path oriented. Here everything is path oriented. It will going to check each and every path, and it will going to add the delay produced by each and every component in each and every path, right? Then
in dynamic timing analysis, we don't check each and every path.
That is also again a tool. Okay, CAD tool will only going to do that dynamic.